Welcome back everyone to theCUBE's live coverage here in Paris, France. I'm John Furrier, host of theCUBE. We're here, wall-to-wall coverage for 2 days for the Raise Summit, NYSE Wired Communities here, that's theCUBE, and the New York Stock Exchange working together to bring you all the open source content, all the access to the data. Nyanya's here, she's the regional VP of the UK Markets for Motive, fast growing company in the US, now heading up in the UK, setting the table for the expansion. Nyanya, thanks for coming on theCUBE.
Thanks for having me.
Appreciate it. So you guys are doing really well. You're here to set up the expansion for Motive. We are in Paris. It's an international vibe. Good food, good wine, good transportation, you know, trains mostly. You guys are growing, and I love what you guys are doing because it's the physical world meets AI. And it's not obvious to the hype around the best LLM, I got the GPUs. There's a real business value going on in Motive. Talk about what Motive does and what attracted you to join the company.
Yeah, so I think at a very high level, Motive builds advanced AI-powered technology that supports businesses operating in the physical economy to run safer, more productive, and more profitable operations. We actually support over 100,000 businesses and 1.3 million drivers across a wide range of industries.
Yeah.
So you think logistics, transportation, field services, construction, energy, even public sector as well.
Yeah.
And this ranges from sort of small businesses all the way to very large enterprises. So some names that might be familiar to your viewers are FedEx Freight, DCC Propane, Halliburton, Carvana, Kone, you know, the list goes on.
Yeah.
So where we really kind of like differentiate ourselves is on the fact that we're the only platform that unifies safety, operations, and finance in a single system.
Yeah, the autonomous vehicle market is hot right now. I was talking to an entrepreneur in the US. He's a very specialty vehicle. It's very small, but it's like one of these cart kind of things. And I'm like, oh, this is super cool. He's been doing it for like, I'd say 7 years, but he nailed the fleet management for his specific thing. It's electric, so a lot of nuanced operational things that go on in these physical workflows that are well known by the domain experts. And so the idea of autonomous, when I say, oh, you could do this outside, I say, whoa, whoa, hold on. You got to get the blocking and tackling done right because there's so much cost savings and operational things to do in the physical side if you want to go software and even be ready for autonomous. But I think what Motive has done is, to me, is the beginning of what you got to do to go there, because it's this value.
There's value, and there's, I think, you know, AI and the physical economy definitely sort of like belong together. And I think, you know, if it's one perspective that we want to amplify in this conference, whether it is to your viewers or the tech world, is like, marrying AI and the physical operations actually generates real value for our customers, right? The industries that we serve, the ones I mentioned earlier on, transportation, construction, energy, oil and gas, they're the backbone of the global economy.
Yeah.
They generate 50% of global GDP. Yet, up until recently, they've been wildly underserved by modern technology, let alone AI.
Yeah.
A lot of the companies we speak to still operate very manual processes, like, you know, think clipboards, spreadsheets, in some respects, even gut instinct, right?
Yeah.
And this is where Motive really shines, because we understand, you know, what it takes to perform in these sort of like high-stakes environments. Because AI has to work in the physical economy, right? The stakes are so high. The difference between, if AI doesn't work in the physical economy, and when I say physical economy, I mean sort of like in the front lines. We've seen AI transform or evolve from being like a back office automation tool to one that's driving decision making in the field. So think cost control, safety, maintenance, compliance, and so on, right?
Yeah.
But the margin for error is very low, right? If AI doesn't get it right, people can get hurt. So that's why for us at Motive, we have stress-tested our AI models to ensure that they perform when it matters in very high-stakes environments.
Yeah, safety, you mentioned safety, that's a huge deal. Let me get into some of the scope of the opportunity, because the physical world, I like how you brought that in, because when you think about like construction, transportation, there's a lot of hardware involved, okay? There's a lot of physical things. Supply chain, materials, and there's also operations at different scales, right? You have larger scale, say fleets, for example, I can relate to fleets because I used to work for a company that had fleets of cars. Little things used to bother people, like, you know, the maintenance costs. All kinds of things are going on in the real world that, if optimized, produce massive savings. That could be quantified.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Can you share some of the things you guys see? Because when you start applying the data with AI enabled, I'm sure it has yield. Can you just share some stories or some examples?
Yeah, absolutely. I would say, you know, our superpower is when we combine sort of like, you know, software, hardware, and AI in one. And when you look at across the board with our customers, we're delivering real transformative impact on safety, operations, and also on financial results, right? Some of the customers I can mention today, Phoenix Global, for example, they're a metals and mining company that rebuilt from bankruptcy with the help of Motive AI. They were able to, over a short period of time, really drive down their operational costs and reduce their safety incidents by 40%.
Yeah.
Ernst Concrete is another company. They're an 80-year-old concrete company came to us after a previous dash cam missed two major incidents, which led to costly lawsuits. So what happened was that we were able to deploy our AI dash cam as well as video-based coaching to be able to help them cut their risk, to boost the visibility, and also ultimately, I guess, protect their drivers.
Yeah.
And over a 13-month period, they saw a 2,000% ROI, as well as $6.5 million in savings. So we're delivering real tangible value for our customers, and that's because of our AI leadership in the industry.
I think that's a great point. One of the things, I'm a big fan of like predicting the market, and I love the bubble conversation because everyone tries to compare this AI bubble to the dot-com bubble, which, by the way, the dot-com bubble, everything did happen, just not the way it was invested in, so it did pop. I think the AI bubble has examples where there's real value being created and extracted, and I think that's a great point. The other point you brought up I'd like to get your thoughts on is what Motive's, I think, cracked the code on is this transformation of the worker. That's a point where people always focus on the job losses, not on what transforms on the human side. Can you share your thoughts on how Motive's involved with turning essentially what could be a blue-collar job into a knowledge worker, because now AI is now assisting. It's certainly dropping money to the bottom line, but in the dash cam example, that's actually creating intelligence, augmenting, mm-hmm. or saving lives in that case, or incidents.
Mm-hmm.
So the role of the worker, productivity,
mm-hmm.
Satisfaction,
mm-hmm.
it's
mm-hmm.
not the daily grind.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, are you seeing, can you share your thoughts on how you guys see that evolving?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sure. So I think AI has been a powerful force. You know, for Motive, AI is not just a feature, but it's a core part of how we operate as a business. We've been able to help our customers, drive significant cost savings, boost safety, boost their safety record, and boost their profitability as well. And I think I would say our superpower at Motive lies in the fact that we are able to really marry all the different components. You've got software, hardware, and AI. We've been investing heavily in AI since 2017, long before the hype, and we're seeing the results really translate to value for our customers.
Yeah, I've been riffing on my CUBE interviews because we talk a lot of startups. They're all hyping up everything. I kind of talk about practical AI. Practical AI is where it's like meat's on the bone. You got real value. It's not just the sizzle, it's the steak, as they say. So like, as you look at these fleets, because I think fleets are something that people can quantify, because fleet management, I like that analogy, because you got big names, and they're actual tangible goods.
Yeah.
That has life spans in terms of durability, and there's costs involved, there's operational costs,
mm-hmm.
and they also are they're used to produce revenue.
They're producing revenue, and as a business, AI has really transformed our business in terms of, how successful, like we're seeing an unprecedented rate of growth at the moment.
Yeah.
And that's validation that there's a demand for this type of technology, marrying AI and physical operations, yeah. right? And that's why we've been so successful. Historically, we focused on the SMB and the mid-market segments, right? And grew a very successful business out of it. I would say hundreds of millions of dollars of ARR. But in the last 2 to 3 years or so, we decided to, you know, we took a bet. Decided to double down on enterprise and heavily invested heavily in our rebuilding our platforms. We deepened our product value, we bolstered our security and compliance features, and we expanded our talent pool to be able to go after a more sophisticated customer. We even rebranded from Keep Truckin' in 2022 to Motive to be able to align better with the problems that we're solving for our customers, which you know, with automation and AI, it goes far beyond the trucking industry, right? It sort of speaks to a much broader vision,
you
right?
You have a bigger TAM too.
Because it's exactly, and what we're seeing, you know, that bet is paying off, right? Last year, for example, we saw 70%. Our enterprise segment grew 70% year over year. Right? Yeah. Making it a fastest growing segment. And you know, equally, we increased both the number of $1 million ARR customers as well as the $100,000 ARR customers as well by 50% year over year. Right? We became cash flow positive in Q4 of 2024.
Yeah.
And we've almost doubled our ARR since our last valuation, $2.85
million.
So the
numbers are great.
The numbers are great, it's working, but it's just validation that there is strong demand for this type of technology, and you know, we're clearly the market leader in that because we've had such a head start in and investing heavily in AI.
I do like the categorical positioning of physical AI world because it's the blending of physical digital, right? And so, this is like classic AI use case, best practice, because you come in on a very narrow scope, fleet, construction, and then, but you're solving a bigger problem that sequences to a bigger opportunity. Mm-hmm. Okay, you were hired to expand out in the UK. I know you don't have any news because it's all under wraps, but can you give us a teaser on how you view the expansion? Because now the TAM's increased, you got I love the enterprise angle, because again, you're solving substitute fleet to data centers or other things, office building, other stuff that's physical. Mm-hmm. I'm imagining that the Motive brain trust is working through that go-to-market and market expansion. Mm-hmm. Why not? Because you solve a lot of the AI problems for physical things.
One thing that has become apparent in my short time at Motive is that whether you're sitting in the US or UK, if you're running a fleet or managing physical operations, you're facing the same challenges, right? And that is, you know, how do you keep your people safe? How do you do more with fewer resources? How do you improve profitability and you know, stay compliant, right? These challenges are not unique to the US. So that's why we're seeing a real opportunity here. In North America, you know, as you rightly mentioned, we've been incredibly successful.
Yeah.
We're now 1 year into our international expansion. So last year we had Mexico. This year will be the UK. So very excited about that. But we're getting, you know, seeing strong demand from businesses here in the UK and also in Europe that are wanting to modernize their operations as well and you know, stay ahead of shifting regulations, particularly when it comes to sustainability, you know, cutting emissions and so forth. And a lot of businesses we see in this part of the world are still using very outdated and siloed systems, right? And
antiquated.
Want a unified platform, you know, powered by AI that's going to help them to really drive down costs and improve profitability.
I love the localization. You mentioned that earlier. In the US, it's 50 states, it's one country. I'm curious, any learnings from Mexico that you're bringing into the UK? And I'm sure that the compliance, it's the same game, but now you have like different pockets. Is that how it works? What's your thoughts on localization? Is it challenging? Do you see it as a heavy lift? Or
for
kind
us,
of a tailwind?
You know, for us, you know, our approach is very much, you know, we have a, you know, global, you know, we're going to take our global muscle, but, you know, apply a very localized playbook, right? Every market that we operate in, we make sure that we are complying with local rules and local norms. We are, you know, for example, UK, EU, we're, you know, GDPR compliant. And every market that we kind of like go out to, it's important for us to listen, to learn, and be able to iterate at pace, right? Because it's you know, they're not necessarily homogeneous, right?
Yeah.
So we have to ensure that even though we can leverage our learnings from Mexico, from the US, we cannot apply a copy and paste playbook here.
I love the global muscle, because the platform is that global muscle and the playbook.
Yeah.
And now you just got to tweak the edges. It's like, you
know, yeah.
It's like any kind of local market.
Exactly. So we definitely, you know, and I think one thing that, you know, we're very good at Motive is the fact that we don't necessarily just want to build for our customers. We want to build with our customers, yeah. Right? So if you look at the unsafe parking alerts, this came directly from customer feedback and we incorporated it into our AI models, right?
Yeah.
So this approach of you know, working with our customers will be something that we're going to be deploying here
and
in the UK.
And AI agents are coming, you get the localization, you can automate that too.
Right, exactly. So there's a ton of opportunity, and I do feel like because of our products and technology leadership, we're definitely well primed to be successful in this market. And we've been speaking to a lot of customers as well and getting really, really good insights and feedback as well.
Yeah, thank you for coming on theCUBE. Thanks for sharing. Congratulations to the Motive and the numbers. Final question, what are you most excited about right now in terms of the market? Because you have a business challenge which you're going to tackle. We'll be tracking that. But just, it's a really interesting time right now. It's like, if you're an innovator and a builder, you can go fast, intentionally fast, or slow down at the right time. There's a lot of opportunities. What are you most excited about?
I'm so excited about bringing our products to the UK market, and ultimately, you know, to Europe as well. There's so much untapped potential in this market.
Yeah.
You know, we're just scratching the surface, as you mentioned earlier on, right? The TAM is huge, and it's ever expanding. 50% of global GDP, and we're barely just scratching the surface, right?
Yeah.
So I'm excited about bringing Motive's superior products to the market, learning and seeing how we can save more lives in this part of the world, as well as livelihoods. Because it's not just about saving lives, but it's about improving productivity and also driving profitability for businesses that are powering our global economy.
Yeah, this is the blocking and tackling of countries and the economies themselves. You guys are powering that. Thanks so much for sharing here in theCUBE. Really appreciate it. Thanks for coming on, appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
Okay, I'm John Furrier here at theCUBE, bringing all the action. We're fast and furious here in Paris. Thanks for watching.